I've only been here for 3 weeks working with the refugees, but so far I've been really, really encouraged by the joy and hospitality that they still have and pride. Right now they're going through a situation that I can't relate to at all, especially coming from the West. These horrific things that they share with us just leave me speechless. But each family we've encountered has welcomed us into their home, and they still find reason to celebrate. And I'm so encouraged and challenged to myself and what it means to have joy and happiness.
أول مرة بروح على المدرسة هاي من سنتين طبعا من سنتين أول مرة أما بسوريا قد ما بنقطع من المدرسة حتى بالعطلة الصيفية بنقوم نبكي إمتى بتخلص هالعطلة
Since being here, the verses in Ezekiel have really been on my heart when he's talking about God shows him the valley of dry bones. But he reminds Ezekiel of his promise to the people of Israel and that they will be restored and God will breathe new life into them and build up the land that's dry and seems like a wasteland, that God will restore it 10 times more than what it was.
جينا قبل الحرب بشي كم يوم بشي 4 أيام شفناهم عم يضربوا الأولاد فهمنا جينا قالوا لنا إنه في مدرسة بعد بكرة ضحك علينا ونحن عايشين لهم
Father, I just thank you so, so much for the Syrian people, Lord, and I thank you for their culture and what they give to this world, Lord. And in this time, I just ask that you just continue to be their comforter in this time when fear can feel like it's strangling them or whatever else. God, I just ask that you let your peace overcome them, God, and remind them of your promises and your hope and the love that you have for them, that they're not a forgotten people, God, that you still love them and care for them and adore them, and that, you will be their solid rock and, come through with your promises that you have for them. God, in your name. Amen.
شو بتحبي تصيري بعدين لما تكبري؟
انسان هلا نيالا الانسان اللي عم تعلمنا وشو في محلاتها